O nome de Keanu? Hyperblower. But Mr. Ifeanyi Ejiofor makes important announcements. This was the news headline. You're welcome to the Des News. Read the details below. Greetings, Umu Chineke, and our noble fans. As you are already aware, that Wednesday, being the 10th day of November 2021, is another day for yet another legal fireworks. I have been off my handles for a while because a lot has been done to ensure that all T's are crossed and I's dotted. We are praying fervently for a fruitful outing that will secure an unconditional release of our indefatigable client, Oyedo Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. Thank you all for all your support and prayers. May you all remain hugely blessed. Note that it shall surely end in praises. Umu Chineke, thank you all. The lawyer to the indigenous people of Biafra leader, Ejimafor, has made an important announcement. Recall that the trial of Mazi Nnamdi Kanu was rearranged to November 10, 2021 for further hearings. And now, the hip-hop has dedicated the day as yet another legal fireworks. They are so sure and they are asking that they should pray for Mazi Nnamdi Kanu. And they are sure that it's going to be released on that day, and it will surely end in praise. That nothing is going to hinder Mazi Nnamdi Kanu to be released unconditionally on that day. This is coming in when Nnamdi Kanu's lawyer reveals why IPOP is not a terrorist group. Alo Ejimakor, special counsel to Nnamdi Kanu, pro Biafra agitator, has revealed why the indigenous people of Biafra, IPOP, is not a terrorist group. Ejimakor disclosed that IPOP has fixed and open addresses across the world, unlike terrorist groups. In a tweet, Ejimakor stressed that IPOP has the right to agitate for a cessation. He explained that cessation usually leads to the birth of a new nation. The council also maintained that the separatist group is non-violent. The IPOP I defend is not a terrorist group. It's also not a violent group. It's not a crime to desire a separate country. That's how new nations are created. Terrorist groups don't have fixed and open addresses. Meanwhile, IPOP has fixed and open addresses in many countries of the world, Ejimakor tweeted. IPOP has been declared a terrorist group by the federal government. They are terrorists because they are creating unpeace in the state. Now, the special counsel to Nnamdi Kanu, Alo Ejimakor, has stated the reason why IPOP is not a terrorist group. That a terrorist group does not have a fixed account and fixed address. They don't have a fixed address. IPOP has a fixed address all over the world. You can get them via the addresses. But as a terrorist does not have a fixed and open address. They stay in the bush. They hide their faces so that people will not see them, so that they will not know their address or where to come and pick them. But the high pub has a fixed address whereby they are open to all over the world. So the federal government should not tag them as terrorist group because they are not a terrorist group. They are just agitating for a separate country. They are just desiring a separate country, and they are not terrorists. They are HIPOP Biafra. Breaking news: HIPOP lawyer Barrister Ifeanyi Ejiofor gives new updates about visit to Nnamdi Kanu in DSS custody. Today, I and my colleague, Barrister Aloy Ejimakor, had a very fruitful visitation to Onyede Mercy Nnamdi Kanu. We discussed a wide range of matters, especially concerning hearing in his court, in his case, and appearance in court. The coast is now clear for legal fireworks, particularly now that we have been served with a purported amended charge in the case. Onyede Mercy Nnamdi Kanu is in good spirits, awaiting his auspicious outing. He commended those who are in the spirit with him, while declaring that Chukwu Okike Abiyama has ordained the special day for a victorious outing. He requested that the fasting, supplications, and prayers should continue, as he noted that they are strongly impacting positively. In the interim, it is necessary to pass the following urgent and important messages, which are: 1. Onyedu made it categorically clear that none of his lawyers should be harassed, threatened, or accused by anybody claiming to be his supporter or follower, regardless of the person's tie with him. 2. That anybody engaged in such harassment, threats, an unfounded accusation directed against his lawyers is definitely working against him, and that he shall never forgive such persons and shall eternally see such persons as his enemy. 3. That the person anybody claiming to be his supporter or follower can do to for him at this point in time is to wholeheartedly support all his lawyers in their current efforts. 4. That any such threats, harassment, and false accusations against any of his lawyers should cease forthwith. Thank you for listening to today's news. Enjoy the rest of your day.